Welcome to my channel. So today we are going to solve one interesting problem related with the discrete time Fourier transform. Okay, the use of discrete time Fourier transform in the system analysis. Okay, so you see the question. A causal system has input x of n and output y of n. Find the system function. So the first question is that we have to find system function. What is mean by system function? Capital H of Z. Okay, system function or transfer function we have to calculate. And the next one is we have to find impulse response. What is impulse response? Small h of n. It is called as a impulse response. So what is the relation between the system function and impulse response? If we are taking inverse Z transform of the system function, we will get the impulse response. Okay, and another one, we have to find the frequency response h of e power j omega. What is frequency response? That is the system equation means capital H of Z. Okay, the Z transform of the impulse response is called as a system function. Similarly, the DTFT of this impulse response, we are calling it as a frequency response. Okay, so the given data is that you see X of n equal to del of n plus 1 by 6 del of n minus 1 minus 1 by 6 del of n minus 2. And output y of n equal to del of n minus 2 by 3 del of n minus 1. So here input and output is given. We have to find out capital H of Z, capital H of e power j omega and small h of n we have to find out. Okay. So from the previous problems, in the previous problem, the input output equation is given. So from that system equation, we calculated the impulse response, system function and frequency response. But here the input value, x of n value is given, y of n value is given. From that, we have to find the three things. Okay, so this problem is somewhat different problem. So anyway, so the first thing you have to write x of n. Okay, given x of n, you just write. So x of n equal to del of n plus 1 by 6 del of n minus 1 minus 1 by 6 del of n minus 2. Okay. Then we want the first thing is system function. What is mean by system function? The system function is nothing but h of z. So the h of z is nothing but it's a ratio of y of z divided by x of z. That is, it's a ratio of Z transform of the output divided by Z transform of input. We are calling it as a system function or transfer function. Okay, so in order to find the H of Z, we have to find X of Z and Y of Z. Okay, so here X of n is given. So we have to convert this time domain input into Z domain. So that's why we have to take Z transform. Okay, we have to take Z transform for the above equation. So what is the Z transform of the term X of n capital X of Z equal to what is the Z transform of del of n? That is already we solved this problem in the fourth unit. Okay, so you know the Z transform of impulse signal. What is the Z transform of impulse signal? You know the value, it is a 1. Okay, plus 1 by 6 into what is the Z transform of delayed impulse according to the time shifting property of the Z transform. The del of n is having the Z transform answer is 1. Then del of n minus 1 means the Z transform answer is that Z power minus 1 into the particular 1. Okay. Then similarly, minus 1 by 6 into what is the Z transform of del of n minus 2? The Z transform of del of n minus 2 is that Z power minus 2 into 1. Okay. So this is the thing. Then so X of Z we calculated. Similarly, the output, the time domain output is given. What is the time domain output is given? Y of n equal to del of n minus 2 by 3 into del of n minus 1. Okay. So for the above equation, you just take the Z transform. So if you are taking Z transform for the above equation, what is the Z transform of Y of n? It is a capital Y of Z. Equal to what is the Z transform of del of n? The same 1. Then minus 2 by 3 into what is the Z transform of del of n minus 1? It's a Z power minus 1. Okay, so that's all. So after calculating the X of Z and Y of Z, we have to find the system function. That is our question. So what is H of Z? It's a ratio of or the output y of z divided by x of z. So that's why you substitute this. This is the x of z value. This is equation number one, and this is the equation number two. So we have to substitute the value of y of z, x of z here. So we will get 1 minus 2 by 3 z inverse by 1 plus 1 by 6 z inverse minus 1 by 6 z power minus 2. Okay, this is the system function. So the first question we calculated. Okay, and the second one, what is the second thing? We have to find impulse response. And what is the third thing? The frequency response h of e power j omega. Okay, so the frequency response h of e power j omega, it is nothing but similar to the system function. The system function means we are taking z transform for y and x, we are taking the ratio. Similarly, the h of e power j omega means y of e power j omega by x of e power j omega. Or simply we are saying it as the frequency response h of e power j omega equal to the h of z at z is equal to e power j omega. Okay, that is in the place of the variable z. If you are substituting e power j omega, that is the answer for the h of e power j omega. Okay, so that's why in the h of z equation, instead of z, just if you are substituting the variable by e power j omega, means we will get the frequency response. Okay, this is the relation between z transform and DTFT. Okay, in the place of z, if you are replacing e power j omega, means the DTFT answer will come. Okay, so the frequency response calculated. And what is the next thing? Next thing, we have to calculate the impulse response h of n. Okay, so what is mean by impulse response? Impulse response h of n is nothing but it's an inverse z transform of the system function h of z, or inverse DTFT of this h of e power j omega. Anyway, we can calculate, we will get the same answer only. Okay, so when comparing the two DTFT, the z transform method is easy. Okay, it is simple. In DTFT means the variable is e power j omega, somewhat complex. Okay, but in the z transform method, simply the variable is z. Okay, so we can easily obtain the inverse method. Okay, so the impulse response h of n is nothing but inverse z transform of h of z. Okay, so you just write h of z. This is the h of z. So here you see the h of z term is having negative z powers. Okay, so while calculating inverse z, we have to convert into positive z powers. That's why you just multiply both numerator and the denominator of this h of z by z squared. So we will get the numerator. If you are multiplying this numerator term with z squared, we will get z squared minus 2 by 3 into z squared into z power minus 1 z divided by z squared plus 1 by 6 z minus 1 by 6. Okay, so what is the next thing? We have to factorize this denominator polynomial. So if you are factorizing this denominator polynomial, we will get z minus 1 by 3 into z plus 1 by 2. So using calculator or using the formula, the roots of the second order polynomial is that minus b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, you just calculate. Okay, so we will get the two roots. One is 1 by 3, another one is minus 1 by 2. Okay, so you can write. Then in the numerator, you take z as a common. So if you are taking z as a common, we can write z into z minus 2 by 3. Okay. Then already you know, that is before partial fraction expansion, we have to keep one z here. That's why that z I am keeping in the left side denominator. So the h of z by z is equal to like this. Okay. What is the next step? In partial fraction method, this h of z by z can be written as a by the first one plus b divided by the second one, you just write. Okay, then we have to calculate the value of a and b. So how a is calculated? A is equal to what is the value under a? Z minus 1 by 3 multiplied with this total left-sided function h of z by z at z is equal to the particular value 1 by 3. So here, the z minus 1 by 3, z minus 1 by 3 cancel. That is, we have to substitute the value of h of z by z. What is h of z by z? This total thing. Okay. So this total value, if you are substituting here, this term cancelled. So in the remaining term, instead of z, we have to put 1 by 3. Okay. So after substituting 1 by 3, we will get the answer A as minus 2 divided by 5. Okay. Similarly, we have to calculate. Okay. We have to calculate the B. So B is nothing but the value under B into h of z by z at z is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, so in a similar method, you just calculate. So you will get the answer 7 by 5. Okay, then after calculating A and B, we have to substitute the value of A and B in where? The equation number 1. Okay, this equation number 1. So the h of z by z, it can be written as A by this one plus B divided by this one. Okay, so then this z, you just give it to the right side term. So the h of z equal to minus 2 by 5 z by z minus 1 by 3 plus 7 by 5 z by z plus 1 by 2. Okay, so then what is the next thing? We have to find inverse the transform. Okay, since we want the impulse response h of n. What is h of n? The impulse response is nothing but it's an inverse the transform of the capital H of z. Okay, so you just take inverse the transform of the above partial fraction value. So we got minus 2 by 5 into. So what is the inverse that transform of z by z minus 1 by 3? It's a 1 by 3 to the power n u of n. Similarly, 7 by 5 into. What is the inverse that transform of z by z plus 1 by 2? This z plus 1 by 2, it can be written as z minus of minus 1 by 2. So the answer for this one is minus 1 by to the power n u of n. Okay. So this is the impulse response of the given system. Okay, this is the method. Okay, so simple one. First, for the given x of n and y of n, you just take z transform. Then you just divide. We will get system function. Then in the system function equation, instead of z, if you are substituting e power j omega, we will get frequency response. And if you are taking inverse the transform of the h of z, we will get h of n. Okay, or otherwise, you take inverse dtft of this h of e power j omega, we will get a h of n. Okay, in both method, we will get the same answer only. Okay, this is the impulse response of the given system. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. And in the next video, we are going to solve one more analysis problem. Okay, thank you.